So now we're in it talking about fats, also known as lipids. We're not talking about adipose tissue. Adipose tissue is fat in the body. Remember that from our module on body composition. We're talking about the things that you consume that are fat. So we have visceral, we have storage fat, that's adipose. Now let's talk about the things that we consume. Yes, you need them. They are a good thing. But again, they've just been demonized, ripped apart for several years. And so hopefully we can kind of reconcile and put this more in perspective for you. And that's kind of the reason I've implemented some of these supplemental videos that you're going to watch after this one. But fats are lipids. And lipid, by virtue of the word, is typically, again, thought of as a bad thing, connected heavily with like cholesterol, but also heart disease and different things like that. I'm not going to get into that so much in this video. I'm going to leave it open for some interpretation in the other videos. But it is very calorie dense, 9 calories per gram. That's twice, over twice as much as proteins and carbohydrates. Also, what you look at here is this is an energy. It's the most concentrated form of energy in our body. And so we don't typically think about fat as energy. We think about fat more kind of like as something that we're going to use, again, storage fat. So we're thinking insulation. But this is actually one of the predominant energy stores. And when you run out of glucose or carbohydrates, this is what you're going to use. And it can be used very efficiently. And so I read an article in preparation for this talk that said that fats are not a efficient energy source for the brain, but they can be. And it kind of was trying to pick on ketones, but it neglected to talk about conversions of fatty acids and how the brain can be fat adapted. So I want you to do your own research out there and find out, are fats good for you? And then ultimately, if you want the gold standard, try it out yourself and self-experiment. But anyways, these are typically stored for use later. It's not like we use fats as immediate energy sources. That's where carbohydrates really kind of tend to shine over fats for energy. And then there are two types. There's non-essential fatty acids, which means that the body can't make them, or the body makes them and it doesn't have to consume food to get them. And then there's essential fatty acids, and those are not made in the body and they must be consumed. And so we look at this and we understand that there are two larger variations of fat characteristics or categories here. Number one, saturated fat. I put you a picture of butter because it's the best identifying example for a saturated fat. Obviously, you've probably cooked a meal like that contained meat, and then you put it in the refrigerator, and you see this stuff kind of gather to the top. That's saturated fat. It literally is a solid when it gets cool, but it's a solid at room temperature as well. Animal meats have a lot of saturated fat. Plant oils have a lot of saturated fats. Dairy, another form, processed meats. And then I want to initiate this term with you, processed foods. And this is kind of something we're going to pick on a little bit later in the next module here. But just so you know, processed foods, prepackaged foods, things that you buy in vending machines, on the cereal aisle, on the chip aisle, basically inside aisles of the grocery store, those are processed foods. We're going to get into more of that later. I included a study here though, because historically, our food pyramid has said less than 10% of your caloric percentage per day should be a saturated fat. But then I've included this study right here, and this study is really kind of unique. It's a meta-analysis, and what it did was it looked at studies and said, hey, look, we're just trying to identify saturated fats are really, really bad. And they said there's no significant evidence after looking at all these studies about saturated fats that can conclude that dietary saturated fat is associated with increased risk of coronary heart disease or cardiovascular disease. So listen, that's a really big statement to make, especially in the era that we live in that has demonized saturated fats. So maybe these things right here, not so bad. You know what? You read the research. You make the decision on your own. But definitely give me some feedback on what you think. There are also unsaturated fats. And these are typically what we think of are the fats with the halo on. And these fats definitely do get some very good feedback from people, especially if they're including them daily into their nutritional intake. But one of the things we know is that about an unsaturated fat versus a saturated fat, you know, if I click back up here, saturated just means they're hydrogen saturated. Saturated kind of gets a bad, you know, vibe just from the word. Unsaturated just simply means that they're not saturated with hydrogen only, but they include oxygen. Oxygen's a very important thing. We like oxygen. You don't want me to take that away from you. And so unsaturated, just get an oxygen bond. Maybe they only get one, so they're monounsaturated. Maybe they get multiple, so they're polyunsaturated. But that's the biggest difference. Now, these are typically liquid at room temperature. Now, I've asterisked that because that's not always true. When we think about liquid room temperature fats, we think oils. And that's wonderful to start with. But there's some other things here. And what you know is that olive, peanut, canola oil, that fits the bill. But an avocado doesn't. And by the way, I love avocados. If you bring me one, you're my best friend. But an avocado is just simply not liquid at room temperature. But it is an unsaturated fat. It's a monounsaturated fat. So are almonds. Again, that doesn't fit this liquid at room temperature description. Some polyunsaturated fats that we really like for you to talk about. Sunflowers and sunflower oil, also sunflower butter. If you haven't tried that, please do me a favor and give that a little pickup at your supermarket. Flax and flaxseed meal are also great unsaturated fats. Fish, canola, which yes, it's an unsaturated fat, but there are some other things that go along with that that I simply am not a fan of. In fact, I would not recommend that you use canola oil, but you know what? That's pretty highly used in not just restaurants, but in homes. And then finally, we kind of end up here with our essential fatty acid, omega-3s. Again, things our body can't make and needs, but omega-3s have an amazing power. We're going to look more of that as we get into diet and what all that does. But I'd like for you to take just a minute to consider, am I getting enough omega-3s? Chances are you're getting plenty of omega-6s, but the omega-3s, probably not. And that's DHA, ALA, and EPA. And I want to tell you, the day that I started really getting the recommended dose of omega-3s, my life literally changed. I'm going to talk more about that in a video down below in vitamins and minerals. Trans fats, and this is the one that does deserve some demonization to it. It's absolutely poison, but it's so saturated, and I'm not using saturated like hydrogen saturated. It's so saturated, and I really probably shouldn't even use that term because I'm connecting the two in a bad way, but that is where you get a lot of trans fats. So anyways, trans fats, though, they're so heavily saturated in processed foods. You grab a bag of chips. You used to grab a bag of chips and you would find that they had trans fats. Now they're really starting to look at that and yank those out. But one area they're not getting them out of, fast foods right here. So all that stuff that you like, your onion rings, your french fries, your hamburgers, the buns, which are poison, but these donuts right here, that's where trans fats just thrive. And it comes from a process known as hydrogenation. And this is more of the artificial type of trans fats. And what I want you to kind of think about is peanut butter. And I give a video down here below where I'm showing you some different things about peanut butter, but a hydrogenated peanut butter versus a non-hydrogenated peanut butter. And I even include one in there that says natural. That's great because it just gives you an idea of the schemes and scams of the grocery business here. But in 2013, the FDA, the Food and Drug Administration, they said, no more, stop it. You're not putting trans fats in our foods. And so they were able to basically use law to leverage away from this because they found out how bad this actually was for us. And this, again, this is why fats get a bad name, is because, you know, there's one part of it. But you go back to unsaturated fats and you understand just how beneficial they are. And we'll look at that as we progress through this module in the next. Mostly in fried, processed margarine, a great place to find you some trans fats, although they've been kind of marketed out. But that's not always true. Anything that has less than 0.5 grams can be labeled zero trans fats, right? Another scam by the grocery business, maybe the government, but you're still getting trans fats. Now, why is that a problem? Watch our video below that talks about the dangers of trans fats, and that will give you more information about that. But you also want to look for partially hydrogenated. You also want to look for hydrogenated, and you want to avoid it. So when I say that, I'm asking you to consider looking at food labels. And you know what? When you start looking at food labels, you'll start identifying things that you can't pronounce. And that's where the buck hits the road, right? So take a look at this article. Heart.org, Healthy Living, talks all about trans fats. It's going to give you some great information about trans fat specifically and heart disease. So what should I do for fats? Well, you got to eat the right fats. What are the right fats? You're going to go to this video, you're going to take a look, and you're going to see what are the right fats. I hope you really enjoy that content. Next, we're heading to carbohydrates. I will see you then. Still